up? It's been a long time. Well, I just wanted to make like a little video because I'm sure like I've never mentioned it on here. If I have, I don't remember. That I do wear like cover up makeup on my face because I have these really bad white spots. So if I'm not wearing any makeup, they look really bad, as you'll see when I clean my face in the video. I noticed, because I know other guys that do it, not just gay guys, that do it like for acne scars or just like other people that have the same like stuff that I do going on with their face, because makeup shouldn't just be like for girls, even though it's typically just for them. So check it out and give me your feedback. Okay, so what you're gonna want to do is make sure that your face is clean. I usually like clean it with, you know, your cleaners, but right now it's pretty clean, so I'm just gonna wipe it down with the BB wipe. And yeah. See how there's spots. You can clearly tell that there's no makeup. You can see the spot. Okay. So once it's, you know, pretty dry, you may want to pat it with a napkin. You're gonna want to put a bit of moisturizer on it. Just a little bit. You can use any like facial moisturizer to fit your skin. My face is very oily, so I try to use a an oil-free lotion. I'm using this sensitive skin. My skin is pretty sensitive. Sensitive skin sunblock lotion from mom, but I'm using it. Neutrogena. Okay. So I've got a bunch of different products, and this one's actually the one that I really, really like because it really matches your skin very well. And you don't have to use a lot, so it doesn't look cakey. Like I've got other stuff, like the. I mean, it's because I'm dark skinned, so it's hard to find stuff. You can probably go to a Sephora and they can match you, or you can just try Sephora like I did. But I went in and it's called Makeup Forever Professional Full Cover Extreme Camouflage Cream, and it's waterproof. It's number 16. Let me just see it. I got it for like $30. I'm gonna use one of these little foundation brushes and just put a little bit. And I can't tell right here, but I'm gonna need a mirror, a little bit. But even like now, you can kind of see how. So I went to get a mirror because I couldn't look in the. Just make sure that you put it everywhere. If you get some on your eyebrows or your hair, it doesn't matter. Just we'll take care of them in a little bit. Okay, so once you've already got it everywhere, see, you're gonna wanna set it. You can use powders depending on what makeup you buy. Whenever I find a foundation that works really good that has like my color, there's no need for you to have like powder, you know, any type of setting powder. What I use, it's by MAC. It's the white, it's the prep, it's called the prep MAC prep and prime. and it was really good. It basically is like a clear powder. Oh yeah, once you say before I cut, you set the whole foundation. You don't want to wait for it to dry. I use a blow dryer. This one's pretty fast drying, but others haven't been as fast drying. Fast drying as this one. I love this one. So anyways, you use the powder. You just kind of shake it a little and get it. And you just start putting it everywhere. Lightly, because a little goes a long way for both. And this is just to set it, and so it doesn't look so like makeupy, oily, like shiny, basically. A more natural type of look. And for this, I use a brush. It's a powder brush. I got it at Walmart. I've tried different brushes and they all suck. This one's pretty cheap at Walmart, and it works. It lasts a while. And then, like, you think you feel around. I'm a little wet spot. Not wet, but you know what I mean. Like, it doesn't feel smooth. Like, damp or something? I don't know how to explain it. Yeah, see? Pretty smooth now. This is not the best color lighting in this room. Now what I do after that is done. Remember how I said if it goes on your eyelashes or whatever? Eyebrows. What I do is I kind of, and it goes on my facial hair too. I kind of took a little coating, not like a big old massive thing, just like a little coating, so that it's not, you know, you don't see makeup spots on there. It kind of cleans it up. It doesn't make it like, I just do it. You do whatever you want. But this is what works for me, and whatever, it's my tutorial. Then I put like you don't want to put in here like too much, because you don't want to look cakey on your eyebrows. But this is kind of to clean them up. See the difference between the two? And if you even want to like do it on your eyelashes, it'll clean them up a little bit too, and it won't make them all long, because you're just kind of doing it with, it doesn't really have anything on here anymore. It's just kind of cleaning it up and leaving a little dark coat. Yeah, and then I have a mole right here. It used to like be really noticeable, but I guess like after like shaving so many times, I've shaved off little pieces, so it doesn't show that much. And you can blow dry this if you want. And then just so it'll dry and set, but it's pretty set right now. But see, now you can't see like those spots that I had. If you guys go on my MySpace, you guys will see pictures, and you can't like see the spots as much as you could in the first little segment of the video. Well, that's my video, and try to figure out any other tips. If you guys have any suggestions in makeup or questions, feel free to. Yeah, bye.